Good morning, everyone. I want to talk real quickly on this YouTube channel some important discussions that I want to speak to you about. Number one, I want to talk about the World Trade Center in New York City. My thoughts on the subject. And really get a lot of people to understand that I get bothered quite a bit when it comes down to the World Trade Center and what happened, because I wasn't in New York City at the time, but I had witnessed what happened when... Basically, at the time that the Trade Centers got hit, I was sitting in Springfield, Missouri. This is like, we're talking about a good 4 or 5 years before I came to YouTube. I witnessed the horror of what happened that day.
Let them know at the same time that was going on, I was in severe pain. I had to go in for an operation.
Yeah, my wife had to go with an operation at the time when it happened. But to me, I had this gut feeling that morning when I witnessed it that something was not right. I couldn't pinpoint it. I'm like, I got up that morning and my wife looked at me and she said, Kenny, what are you doing? I said, I got to check the news. I just got this funniest feeling. And I can't explain the feeling to a lot of people because it's something that, you know, you have a gut feeling. And I turned around and I told her that morning before we found out what happened. I said, look, I'm going to tell you something. Something's happened. And I can't explain this to you. I got to see the news. And so I turned it on. And it was the CBS Morning News with Brian Gumbel. And lo and behold, he was sitting here talking. And he sat there and he said, I don't know what's happened, but the World Trade Center is on fire. I think in a lot of ways, Brian Gumbel was in shock and awe when it first happened. And then later on, he said, we are getting reports that an airplane ran into the World Trade Center. And it was some sort of accident that had happened. And while he was sitting here talking on the news, I sat there and saw the second plane. And the whole shock that Brian Gumbel had at the time, he couldn't believe what he's like, I just saw something. I don't know what it was. And then he rewound the tape. And that's when it dawned on him, like, oh my God, there was a plane that went into the second tower. And this wasn't an accident. I couldn't get my mind off of what happened when the planes went into the World Trade Center towers. It took me a while to kind of just like terrorism. Never even heard the term about terrorism before when it had happened. And believe it or not, I didn't even know half the things that was going on with Iraq. With, you know, I knew that we were at war with it. But I mean, more or less, I was ignorant of everything that was going on, and then the realization that how real it was when the World Trade Centers came toppling down. I mean, the whole thing is it was like, I can't, to this day, I still can't understand. And when everyone starts to talk about the World Trade Center, you know, I'm just wanting to bust out crying.
Me too.
About what happened, but I feel like containing my emotions, just doing the best I can to contain the emotions, because I know that when I bust down crying, I'm just going to lose it. You know? The whole point of what I'm trying to say is that when I come on this channel and I'm talking about the World Trade Center, I'm still trying to comprehend just how many people lost their lives that day. How many mothers and fathers was lost that day. And in some cases, there was 4 women on the World Trade Center who lost their lives, and they lost their babies too. In the video that I posted a few days ago, I was reviewing that video, and I noticed like there were 4 or 5 unborn children that had lost their lives. And the realization is that all 4 of these kids will never get the opportunity to see the world that was around them. And then the mothers that will never be able to get to hold them babies in their arms, because they too lost their lives. I watched on the news about how CNN was praising the firefighters. But what a lot of people don't realize is there were 10 officers that was also in the World Trade Center that lost their lives. And out of the rubble that pulling the bodies out of the rubble, only 20 people walked out alive, while almost 2,600 people perished. The whole point of what I talk about on this channel is the importance about how we should always remember the men and women who died at the World Trade Center that day. The number of people that you will never get to meet, you'll never get to speak to, you'll never be able to ever see them again, and how every single family member that was affected in the World Trade Center, to me, when I post a video on YouTube, it's really just explaining my emotions on how I feel that this was probably the worst day in American history. The emotions that I want to really clear is just like, it's just for me, it's therapeutic in a lot of ways because of how that day changed America. You know, I'm not saying here on YouTube to try to become the most famous person on YouTube. But the point of the matter is the importance that talking this out and saying, hey, this is the solution. There is no solution to this. It's how bad the situation was that day. And how much members of their own family misses the people who died in those rubbles. And it was a very, very bad situation. And I can't. I don't know the right way to talk about this or the wrong way to talk about it, other than talking about it. And how we will never forget those people who lost their lives that day. And that's the whole point of why I posted those 3,000 names on that list, because that day really was a wake-up call for a lot of people. And I'm still trying to fathom what I witnessed on television that day. And, you know, the emotion is something that I try to not show, but it's to this day, you know, it's hard to believe that it happened. You know, it's been almost 20 years since 9/11 happened, but yet the realization is I will never forget that day as long as I live. To see what I saw on television really, I can't even put into words. And that's why I really, really, really want people to remember that day and never forget it. And that's what I gotta say. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.